Good evening and welcome to Views with Joyce Waddell. I want to thank you for joining us this evening. We have a very interesting guest. We have Jonathan Rose, who's going to be doing saxophone for you. And we're going to be talking about what led him into this, playing the saxophone, and how it has related to a ministry for him, and the things that he's doing in the community, and how God led him to be a saxophone player later in life. So welcome, Jonathan.
Thanks, good to be here.
Now, Jonathan, many people start playing saxophone, or they do musical instruments, they start fifth grade.
Right.
But you didn't, did you?
No, I never had a lesson in my life.
Never had a lesson?
Never did.
Well, I thought I could do that, so I went to the music store and asked the man. I said, I'd love to play saxophone, because I listened to you and what you said. And he said, no, you don't want to do that. I said, why? He said, because it has 50 notes on it.
Wow.
I said, 50 notes? He said, you never would learn that. Wow. But you did, didn't you?
Well, I'm in the process of learning. I'm still learning. You know, it's a work in progress, so it takes
and,
a lot of time.
And all of a sudden, you were in a church, and a vision came to you.
Yes, I was in the church service. It's been 6 years now. And there was a vision that came in my mind, and the thought was just get a saxophone. And that's what I did. I went and found the cheapest saxophone I could afford. Of course, this is not it, but over the years, we got a new one. So,
yeah. Well, what would have happened had you started in fifth grade?
I don't know. You know, Ms. Waddell, I don't know. I wonder about that myself.
Because a lot of people, they start learning the instrument. Maybe you would have been great, and maybe you would have been, you don't know.
Well, I hope I'll be a lot better than I am now.
Well, you do great work now. And you like to play a lot in the park, you say?
Oh, yes. I love the park. I love the atmosphere. It's just the open atmosphere. And I get
it's a bit of serenity, isn't it?
Oh,
and
yes.
Peacefulness.
Oh, very peaceful. Very peaceful.
But the parks aren't as safe as they used to be, are they?
Well, they have a lot of police officers that come by, and a lot of them know me now, you know, but I try to go up early in the day when the park is full and a lot of people are there. I don't, you know, past 5-6 o'clock in the evening, I'm home. Yes.
And so, have you ever done like street corner ministry where people sometimes play on the street?
Well, yes. It's just certain areas where I allow, they're allowed, you know, some public places they don't allow you to go out there, even if the area is not occupied by a business. It may be owned by someone. So they'll come by and they say, you know, we can't have that here. Because I get kind of loud sometimes out there.
And they say, you can't stay here.
Yeah, they'll say, you know, you're too close to a resident or you're on private property. Or I've even gotten permission to a couple of the malls here in Charlotte. And they say, well, you're going to have to go downtown, fill out a paper. You know, so it's just not worth it a lot of times. So mainly the parks, I stay out there.
If you go in the mall, they say get a paper and get a paper.
Yeah, you actually have anywhere in Charlotte, according to city law ordinance, you have to have a paper stating that you can play here, you can play there. If it's most places here in Charlotte are privately owned or they're owned by a local business and they don't just allow you to just pop up and play. They think you're drawing attention, you're going to have a block party or something, so they don't know what you're doing out there. So, you know, I pick and choose.
Well, I know some people that play instruments, they do drums or something, mm-hmm. and as people going to the stadium or going to an event, and then they make
right.
a lot of money like that.
Yeah, and then you can. People always tip. You know, they throw some money out, and I'll say thank you. You know.
But you don't have to worry about one person throws the money out, another person comes and picks it up.
Not usually. Maybe I guess it depends upon the area that I'm in. But so far, I haven't had that problem. Of course, my wife takes it all anyway. So.
But that people let you know that they appreciate what you're doing.
Yes. Well, I pray that they do. You know, I don't ever know what I'm giving a person by what I'm speaking or by the sound of this horn. But I just know what they say in return when it sounds nice, you know, thank you. I've had so many people in the park say, thank you for playing. I didn't know how to respond to that. You know, I said, okay, well, praise God or something, you know, okay.
And so you have more than one saxophone now.
Yes, I do. I have a soprano saxophone and I have a sopranino saxophone. It's a real small instrument. Yeah.
How'd you know the names of all those if you never saw them before?
Well, just looking in over the few years that I've been playing, I've acquired different sounds for different events. And some horns do certain things, you know. And being that I'm still learning this horn, I haven't got it to where I want it to make got it to make certain sounds when certain people are singing. Like the soprano works good with a lot of female voices. The sopranino works well with a lot of soprano voices because it gets up there in the register and it screams. So I don't play that too much.
But this is your favorite.
Oh yeah, the alto is my favorite. I love the alto.
Now this is the one that President Clinton plays, isn't it?
I think President Clinton plays a tenor. Yeah, it's a little bit bigger. Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah, he's pretty good. Haven't met him yet, but.
But he's known, often you see him playing on different programs or yes. Different events.
Yes, he plays very well. He really does.
And so you're gonna do a song tonight?
Sure, would love to.
And we'll see if your accompanist can get your music together, and as soon as they get it together, we'll love to hear that song.
All right.
Thank you.
let go and let God.
Okay. Did you record that?
No, that's not an original. It's Dwayne Woods is the singer of that song.
But do you write your own song sometime?
Yes, I do. I'm in the process of putting some music together now and working with some musicians, and we'll be putting out some music pretty soon.
Now, do you do better working alone, or do you do better working, is it more satisfaction working with a group?
Well, I would say both, depending upon the venue. Some venues, like at a jazz house or a cafe, a band would be more suitable than just doing a solo performance with a track. You know, it's kind of, but I don't know. There's a lot of musicians that I like working with here in Charlotte. So they actually teach me. So I like working with them as well.
The saxophone is a beautiful sounding instrument because you can do a lot of things with it.
Yes.
But you have to have a lot of wind, don't you?
Yes.
Strong lungs.
You do.
If you don't have strong lungs, you can't play it, can you?
Well, there are different setups. That's the beautiful thing about woodwind instruments. You can adjust the mouthpieces and the reeds to whatever strength that's suitable for you, so you won't have to play as hard. But when you're used to playing in front of musicians and you don't use a microphone, I have it set up to be loud. So playing real soft with this setup is kind of hard, but it's doable. It's doable.
And you just, after you started playing it, you fell in love with it.
Oh yes, I love it. It's a lot of fun and it brings me joy. But the main thing about it, within the ministry aspect, the words that I receive from the people saying how well they were blessed, that does it for me. That's so encouraging.
So you play in the park, and do you play in the park every day?
No, basically on the weekends, because that's mainly when I have a lot of engagements, and I'll go out there and play.
Practice.
Yeah, try to do the whole family thing while I'm there, you know. So it's a lot of fun, and it gets me prepared for playing when I do have to play at an event.
You don't have to worry about anybody running you away from the park, do you?
No, not the parks that I usually go to. They know me, so they usually don't. I have been run away before, though.
From the park?
Yes.
A public place?
Yes, I have. Yes, but it was a gentleman that who didn't know me and didn't know that was something I was doing. He was kind of new to the area, but after a while, he said, "Okay, I know you are now." So, yeah.
And he knew that you meant good. That it was God's work.
Oh yes.
That you were doing.
Exactly. Yes.
So, have you tried to teach anybody else what you know?
Well, I do a lot verbally. Because a lot of times when I run
it's hard to teach somebody that, isn't it?
It is. The first thing that was kind of hard for me was to learn the lingo, because there's a lingo with instruments.
Oh,
and,
really?
Yes, like vibrato. You know, you have all type of growling noises. I was like, what? You know, when I was hearing these things and reading them in the book. But you can discuss over the top about the sax, but when it gets down to learning notes, and you actually need to have this piece of equipment in your hand so you can get used to it.
So you learn those by reading and also from other musicians.
Yes, exactly.
Without having to go and sit in a class 10 hours
right.
a week.
It's what they would consider playing by ear.
You play by ear?
Yes.
Can you
yes.
play other instruments by ear too?
No.
You don't know because you haven't tried.
Well, the keyboard, you know, one finger for me, you know, I don't know chords and all that stuff. And I was always in school a beatboxer. You know, I love the beats and the making music with my mouth, but it turned into playing it with the horn, so, mm-hmm. yeah.
And so you have another song that you're gonna play?
Yes.
Okay, and your accompanist will get that ready.
Yes, all right.
Okay, and as soon as they get that ready, we'd love to hear it.
All right, thank you.
wonderful. Now you almost get out of breath sometimes, don't you?
Yes, it happens.
But you couldn't be a smoker and play this instrument, could you?
I don't think so. But just as I say that, I imagine somebody out there probably proved me wrong. You never know.
But it takes a lot of energy also. It
takes a lot of energy, and there are different types of players. I'm more of an energetic player. I'm kind of holding myself back a little bit. Because, you know, but when you get out there and you just get moved by the spirit of the music that you're playing, and for me, again, it's like you're speaking the words through this horn, so.
And when you're playing the park, people stop, and all of a sudden you have a large group of people looking at you.
That's right. People come about and come around and stand and give me ovations, and I'm not out there for that. You know, for me, it's more ministry, and it gets me prepared. So when I do go out before people, because a lot of people are afraid to play in front of other large congregations or large groups of people, but I love it. The more, the better.
Well, why would they be afraid of that? This is a form of entertainment, isn't it?
Well, now this is a fine line when it comes to playing music, especially in the church. It's entertainment when people pay to have you perform, but outside of that, when I'm playing, I'm just playing, and I'm playing out of my spirit, out of my heart, and I don't really like to label myself as a performer. I just don't. I mean, that's what it is. Technically, you're performing, but when I get on stage, it's ministry for me. It's ministry.
Now, do you ever play with R&B groups?
I've never played with R&B groups, but I keep myself abreast of R&B songs. Play a lot of Luther Vandross, because I do a lot of weddings. Play some Luther Vandross and some secular songs.
Like Dance with My Father.
Oh, I never played it, but that's a beautiful song. A beautiful song, yes.
Or when you play Luther Vandross, which songs do you play?
Well, I like So Amazing. I actually have a track that I play with that, and So Amazing is mainly one of the main ones that I play. And there's a few others, I forget the names right now. But yeah, Luther's one of a kind. Yeah, yeah.
And he had a saxophone player in his band.
Well, I've seen saxophone players on stage performing with him. One thing that I found out with this, with the business aspect of it, we had spoken about the different bands, and mm-hmm. you can have musicians for hire. Like you go to different cities, different states. It's good to have 3-4 keyboard players that you know. Same thing with drummers,
in a
horn players.
State.
Well, yeah. Well, so some of your band members wouldn't mind traveling with you, and some of them are more available for you to do live events than others. So, you know, if I just had one keyboard player and I needed a gig, a book an event, and he wasn't able to do it, I'd be stuck. So I try to surround myself with many musicians so that they'll be available for different events.
Is that what other bands normally do when they put, because I notice a lot of them don't always have the same people.
Yes, well, that's one thing that makes a great band is you getting and working together constantly. And it's kind of hard sometimes.
Because most of them have other jobs.
Right, and family, so it makes it kind of difficult. And that's one of the reasons why I'm more of a solo artist. I can just pick up and go whenever I need, you know. It doesn't give the live feel. But even though I'm playing live, it's just something about a live stage or a live set that brings a different audience.
And so when you play with other groups, you try to connect with them?
Yes. There's a few bands that I'm working with now that even the music and the collaboration, everything has got to be on point. And the keys has to be in the right tone. I mean, you can have the keyboard player playing in one key and you're in another key, and it is not going to work out. It is not going to work out. So it takes a lot of work and a lot of listening and paying
and
attention.
A lot of playing and a lot of being together.
Yes.
And a lot of practice.
Yes, a lot. There's a lot of practice behind this horn.
Well, it takes practice to make perfect, doesn't it?
That's what they say. I'm still working.
And so you're going to do something else?
Sure.
Okay.
I'll do something else.
Okay. We'll tell your accompanist to get it ready, and then you won't hear from me again because you'll probably take us out with
all
it.
All right. Mm-hmm.